Alrighty, good morning guys. It's about 6:15 a.m. Got the truck and dump trailer ready last night. Today is officially the day that I'm doing my biggest job today. So I'm really excited for that. I got the guys coming in about 8:15 in the morning. So right now I'm gonna go grab them donuts and I'm gonna go grab the machine and then head to the job site. Hopefully get unloaded, but the ground is a little bit dewy. So I might have to wait a little bit, but I think with the way the sun is and everything like that, we might be all right. We might be able to start by the time we get to the job, which is gonna be around 8 o'clock, so.
Concrete's still wet. You see my foot's get wet, you know? Just to put it into perspective, you can see this is usually a lighter color, but it's so soaked. Yeah, and all the water and everything.
All right, it's now 7 a.m. I'm at a Bell shop picking up the skid loader. I beat him here, so I'm gonna get the ramps ready and all that other stuff, but there's his shop behind me and a couple of his trucks. So we're gonna get the machine now, and then we're gonna head towards the job site and see how much work we can get done. It's coming out. Walk around the entire place here. All this lava rock, stump grindings, stuff like that. There's a big mound in there, literally sticking up a foot or two. All this is coming out. It's gotta get pitched away from the house. We're pitching it all towards the sidewalk. So this is what it's gonna look like beforehand here. We're taking out a little section in here because there's bushes along here, so this is coming out to probably about here or so. And then we're gonna leave it dirt for them to plant grass. And then over here is where this was all one big bush, I guess, right here. He said the biggest bush he's ever seen. That's been ripped out, stump ground out, and all that stuff. This whole area is getting scraped down to nothing and brought in more dirt and stuff like that. So we're gonna see all these holes left to fill in. Tarp with stuff on it, I guess. I do see that's quite interesting now. Supposedly they didn't come in marked, but I don't know if somebody ripped these out or what. And along here, this is where we're supposed to be, a couple feet off the house. All this lava rock's coming out, all these plants. See, they should have marked this ridge along here. None of it's been marked at all. And you got this stuff out front here. All this is coming out. This edging, gone. This is where it gets really bad. Big hole here, another hole there for the bushes. You can see the difference in elevation here. How low that is. We'll have to bring dirt all the way up to the bottom of that siding, maybe even a little higher. All this is coming out, and it's got to get pitched all that way, which, looking at it, not really 100% sure how this is going to work yet. But we'll see, because that looks about the same height as that. So, not really sure yet, but we'll figure that out tomorrow. And then this little section out here is coming out. Dirt and stuff like that, but just dropped off a load of plywood. It's about 20 sheets. Alright guys, we got the Toro Dingo TX1000, we're about to give it back. Got the bucket on there, loaded diesel. Here's the controls. Got your drive. You got your bucket. I'm clearing the side of my dump trailer, which is good. I had to dump it or push it back with the machine there. But you can see here, give you guys a little update where we're at. We got the New Holland LT28. Been digging around most of the house. We had to wait because they're digging over there with their, they had to come mark that utilities. But this is pretty much all dug out to the sub base. Gotta put the topsoil there. This is all stuff that's gotta come out yet. Side of the house over here, we dug down a little bit. Got most of it out, gotta dig it by hand. This is all good here. I'm trying to figure out what I'm gonna do with the air conditioner. I don't know because it's so low, we might end up having to bring that up, but I won't be responsible for that. Had a little issue there. The dingo was slid right here because it's uneven on the concrete, poked a hole right in the siding. Talked to the customer, he's all cool with it. We'll get it squared away with him. Filled it in a little bit here. I scraped this down. If you guys remember, this was mounted about foot and a half. Scraped it off. We gotta do all the handwork around there yet. Around the back here, dug this out with the dingo. Got most of it, still gotta get the edging. And then we got the back of the place. So we'll get most of it done today. If we don't finish today, we will finish tomorrow. But got the truck over there, all parked, looking nice. Here's our path of travel. We are using the sidewalk. Normally I wouldn't do it, but this is pretty much tight access. So it's fine though. And then we got a well cap there and this there. So the machine just fits through here, which is good. A mini would be ideal, but is what it is. So we are making a big mess. Just dumped the first load. This is what it was. Quite a bit here. I don't know how many yards this is. Probably 5 yards, I'd say, of different dirt and gravel and stuff like that. But the trailer pulled it just fine. No problems dumping it. Just almost got stuck because it just rained a ton last night. So they're cutting it close, but it worked. Now to clean off these tires somehow so I don't track it all off the road. Wish me luck. Guys, what's going on? Just wanted to update you guys and see where, show you kind of where we're at. Just dumped the second load so far. Now I gotta head back to the job site. We're gonna end up coming back tomorrow to finish. I think it's already 4 o'clock, so it is what it is. I kind of thought we were gonna get it done in a day, but run into a lot of, you know, little things like shoveling rock and stuff like that that takes a lot more time than you think. So I'm gonna head back to the job site now and we'll catch up with you guys soon.
We got Eric holding up more brush here. Third trailer load out. Here. That's gonna go all around the house, so we're gonna finish this project tomorrow. Today is it's been a lot of hand digging because it's so tight, but this is the worst area I think of the entire house, so we saved it for last. This is what we're gonna do. We did all this already over here except for that little area we gotta finish. We did that early this morning and then we stopped, so we just gotta do this and then we're pretty much done with the dirty work.
We got a big mess on the driveway. This whole side of the house is done. I believe I showed this before. I can't remember anymore. That's all done. Set that down over there. And then we got this done for the most part. Now it's not done, but we got all the stuff out of here. That's all I wanted to do today, was get the stuff out of here. We got a little bit left to get along this edge. This is all landscape fabric. We got to get this pile and then we're done. So it's just that. This is all done. This thing is huge. It helps tremendously. This is all done over here. Got the guys pretending to work. I'm just kidding. Very thankful for these guys. So this is done over here. all this is graded roughly, and we got to get the topsoil down tomorrow. Come back in the morning and do that. Got to get rid of this edging. All this has to be graded. Pull this stuff out of here. This is all nice and flat, except for down there, it's pitched towards the house. We gotta raise that up to the edge of the side and pitch it all back away from here. And now we're on the other side of the house, as you can see. Gotta get rid of that plywood, probably just put it on the sidewalk overnight and re-topsoil this. This is the one area I'm debating yet. This AC unit is trying to maybe bring that up, but I'm not gonna touch it because I don't wanna be responsible for it. I'll mention it to the customer because it's very low compared to the sidewalk, and you can clearly tell that water would pool up in there, and I feel like it would get in the AC unit, which I don't know if that's a good thing. So that's kind of where we're at. Let me grab this. Oh man, there we go. So yeah, that's what it looks like. I'll show you that dirt pile's out still there in the front. Gotta probably throw that in the driveway overnight. Probably could leave it in the road, but I won't. So throw this in the dump trailer. This is the third load. This was almost full too. But this is what we're doing, man. It's been going pretty good. Nice house. This whole entire house was all bushes before. I wish I can maybe pull up a picture of that on Google Maps or something. But when we were called in here, all the bushes were out, the stumps are ground out. So we just had to get all the lava rock and stuff out. Man, it has been, we have transformed this place. So right now, Eric is just kicking a pile of dirt. Being very helpful. Austin's moving this pile. We're getting it out of the road overnight because I don't know what the rules are around here. But we just got to spread it tomorrow. We're done. Alrighty, here it is. This is where we're going to leave. Come back tomorrow. Moving the 15 yards of dirt. Whew, long day today. Alright guys, this is the start of day two. So we're gonna go spread all that topsoil and stuff. It's about 7:45, running a little behind because so tired from yesterday. Had to sleep in just a little bit, which is what it is, but probably should just go to bed earlier next time, right? Good morning guys, we're on the job site here. Just got the skid loader ready, gotta start it up, warm it up, move all of our plywood back and start spreading topsoil. So here we go. Hoping it shouldn't take too long because most of the base is good. It got it down to pretty much the subgrade that we want. Now it's just going to be a matter of getting the topsoil down, compacting some areas, and just sloping it away from the house. So here we go.
So we got Eric loading up dirt. Got about half of the pile left. I'm going to need more. Still haven't done this area. Haven't done this yet, but I'll take you and show you what we did do. Got it going around the side here. Did this whole back area. We tamped it away from the house too. So it's angled, which is all good, nice and solid. Same with over here, all nice and raked out. And we just gotta finish down the side over here. Move all this plywood out. Rip some of these little plants out. But we started doing this area, but we ran into one issue. There's a pipe in that corner. Found out that it's nothing, so now we're gonna bring some more dirt in and bury that. Continue to pitch it away. You can see we sloped it that way, tamped it down. Then over here, we gotta finish this side of the house too. So we dumped some dirt in there. Now we just gotta finish grading the rest of it. Should take a couple more hours, hopefully. And then we'll be out. So it's been going pretty smooth. Going through dirt a little bit faster than I thought we would. We got about 15 yards. I'd say we probably got 6 or 7 left. So, and we're not even done with the back of the house. So Eric is going the wrong way. So he will turn around now. But this is where we're gonna do next, this area here. I'll show you over here. Cause we had access with the machine from that way. Did up to here, and then we'll bring the machine around here. Fill in our little voids that we made and continue to go along the house. So Eric will bring that around right here. You guys get to see him. Today we got Austin, Eric, and Brody. Eric's bringing it in. Track machine would be ideal, but it is what it is. And then basically we'll just kind of shovel it out because we don't need too much in this area. Shoveling. We got Austin tamping away down here. We're tamping around the perimeter of the house. Got this side all done. Looking good, man. Got a little bit to do over here. A little bit more in the back. Update for you guys. We're working on that back area over there now. Just got to finish that side of the house. Move the plywood, put some more stuff on. We got Eric
removing timbers. Eric, what do you want to say to the YouTube people?
Absolutely nothing. Fantastic. Awesome.
There goes Brody. We got a little bit of dirt left. I'm going to go get more with the trailer. We got to haul out all that stuff. Not really sure where I'm going to take it yet, but we'll figure that out. Then we're going to have to fill in these ruts where the plywood are. So we probably got a yard of dirt left, and we need maybe another five. We'll see. We're looking good though.
I'm gonna believe it. This truck that's coming at us right now drove past our job site because he had the wrong address. And we needed topsoil, and this guy is Scott's Topsoil, and he's cheaper than anywhere else I've ever been. So we're gonna go follow him back to the yard now, because that's what he said to do. And then we're gonna meet up with him and get some prices.
Green stuff at the end there. Look at that. That is some clean stuff.
All right, Sam happy would be an understatement. Check this out. This is 5 yards. This is more like 7 yards of topsoil. Paid $17 a yard for it. The guy drove by this place that we were working at right as we needed topsoil. I just kind of waved to him, didn't think much of it, and then ended up calling the place, found out they were super close, like within probably 4 minutes away. Saved so much time because the other place is a solid half hour drive that I normally go to. So just saved myself a ton of time and a ton of money on this one. Super happy.
Taking dirt out of the trailer. Try and keep it in the trailer as much as we can so it's less ground cleanup with this small of a load. It's only 5 yards. So got Eric running the machine. We got pretty much this whole side of the house done. Just got to do a lot of cleanup work now.
Right now we are back dragging. This area was high to begin with. We added a little too much dirt. So dragging some of it off. Tapering it away from the house here. We got Eric in the skid. Back dragging. He's getting really good with this thing. So I'll show you right now what we just did. Covered up our tracks right there. We used plywood, but it still messed it up. And then back here is all nice and cleaned up. That's all grass that's been raked back. It's all fine. This is the area that we did now. Like this, and this area over here, all done. The whole back of this house is very, very good. I got Eric running the plate compactor. He's doing a really good job. It's a really hard machine to run. It really takes a lot of audio. But it actually does, I'm not gonna lie. So here's the deal, we don't have to tamp down this area, but the reason I am is because I wanna kind of see where the grade is at, and we're doing really good with it. So I don't have a laser or anything like that, so. We're just basically eyeballing it, which is fine, because this area before was mounded with dirt, like a foot or 2 feet high. Scraped all that off, and I put fresh topsoil down. We're compacting it down, then we can see the low spots. Put it down, so. Thanks a lot out of you. Hey, Eric.
Yep.
You're probably gonna quit now?
Yeah, I think so.
All right. And there he goes, he's walking off.
Not a lot on this bucket, but we're at the point where we just need to move material. So that's what we're doing here. Looking good, looking good. Alrighty, so we got Eric in the machine again. Been switching off most of the day. So we just gotta make sure. Got tight access here. The air conditioner and the well right there. So, it works though, we'll be putting topsoil right in this front, no biggie. No damage to the sidewalk, not to worry. We just need to put a little bit more dirt in right here and then we're pretty much done. So right now, other than cleaning up this big pile of mess, guys, check this out. Looking good. But back to this. What we're doing now is we are bringing the trailer down. Eric's gonna dump that little bit of stuff in the front there.
leaking any hydraulic fluid here.
Yeah, we're all dry, which is good.
That's why you guys gotta be careful if you're bringing stuff down in the dump trailer. Take it down slow. That way you don't blow out the hydraulic fluid. All right, we got Eric wrapping up here, finishing up this job, getting whatever's left, all the dust and stuff out of the street. Look at this place. Got marks from the skid loader everywhere. That's all right though. Coming back to get that tonight in about an hour. But I'll take you guys around here. Show you around here. I'll show you up here first. So this area really wasn't our fault at all, but it was so uneven that I just decided to taper it because we had a couple skid steer tracks through here. This area was the absolute worst, if you guys remember. It went down about a foot over there. Now it's nice and flat, ready to go. Over here, nice and tapered all this way. Looking good. So everything is nice and smoothed out, flat, pitched the way it's supposed to be. I love how this looks over here. We tamped this whole side down and it looks phenomenal. Downspouts are coming. Take you guys around the other side here. We did not intend on going too far with the track or the machine, but we had to fill in a couple little holes here. No big deal. Grass will pop right through on those ones. Here's the machine, New Holland 228. Great skid loader. A little big for this job, but sure saved so much time. Machine, that's one of the tire tracks right there, so we had to fill that in. Filled all this in here. Had to put that inside. Flatten this out a little bit here. That's why it's a different color. This has all been cleaned up. You can see this place is very dusty. This AC unit, this is not our fault right here. This, I warned the customer already, this needs to be raised up, and so that's what they're gonna work on next, but they still wanted me to put dirt around it for the time being. So I did what they asked. Over here, everything's looking good. Only thing I gotta do is I gotta fix that little hole. I don't know if I told you guys that story. The dingo the other day, we were so far down, the machine slid, and there was no way of stopping it and just poked a hole in the siding there. So I'll get that fixed for him, no big deal. And then back here, nice and flat too. I don't know if you guys remember, but this was a giant mound. Now it's all nice and flat, pitched the way it should be. So that looks great. Back here, we had another mark from the skid. The plywood kept shifting around on us, so we decided to do that, and we filled in a couple little holes there. The rest of this grass is all just gonna pop back up, but this is what else we did here. This has all been pitched around here. And this looks amazing back here. I love how this turned out. All back and up there. So, and that looks great, because we tamped that whole area, pitched it all this way. So, that's what it looks like.